Welcome to VIP Style. This is the first ever reality show filmed here in the Mahoning Valley. I'm your host, Lisa Neild. You're probably thinking, okay, so who are you? Glad you asked. I've appeared internationally on several magazine covers, as well as pictorials around the world. But that's not even what this is about. This is letting you into my life to show you the many roles that I take on a daily basis, just like you. I'm a mom of two, a marathoner, a model, a radio personality, entrepreneur, actress, charity worker, probably forgot one in there somewhere. So come on, come walk with me, walk in my shoes, and let's see what it's like. This is VIP Style, and remember, image is everything.
Too hard.
All right, we'll grab out the butter, the sticks. All right, let's do one at a time. Stir softened butter. Oh, I gotta soften it.
Ooh, chocolate chips.
I mean, wait, can we eat just one of them?
Just one.
Just one.
All right, to melt the butter, but we only need a fourth of a cup, so we need a half of a stick. Okay. And then we're dropping them on. Okay. Yep. Sorry, it's just added treadmill time. It's probably like 30 seconds. We're gonna try it.
Okay, then what's next?
1 tablespoon of water.
Oh, done, Mom.
Okay, so we're mixing.
Oh no, it said not melted.
Oh. No. Well, let's just add it.
Okay, it's fine. I'm sure it's fine. Okay.
Teaspoon.
What do you think of? Oh wait, a tablespoon. So about a tablespoon, right?
Yep.
Okay. Those both are ancient. No, those were actually Nana's though. Those are my mom's. Yeah. Look! Oh my gosh! They're all the same times. Shiny metal. Shiny metal.
Preheat over.
What?
Put that there.
But it has to be 1 inch apart. What's 1 inch? Is that like an inch?
Probably put. Oh, that's good. Should I start?
Wait,
this?
Hold on. Cookie dance. Do the cookie dance. You're gonna teach me how to do the cookie dance?
You just do a dance bowl with cookies in your hand and then you know.
Really?
It's a new thing.
Oh. I guess I get the memo on that. Just like how I didn't know how to Dougie or whatever it was.
Cat daddy. Something.
Yeah. Teach me how to Dougie. I was like, what?
There's that and then one egg.
Good job, Ab. Okay. I'm just gonna move them a little bit closer, okay, Abs? Oh, that's time. It says it's ready to go. All right, Abs, in they go.
In they go.
In they go.
Now what do we
Timer is on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's say 7. All right, so we know. That's probably curd and Jimbo. Hold on. Or just continue on. Come in.
Are you doing breakfast?
No.
I've seen the egg.
Have a seat. You guys sit down because this is quite entertaining.
I'm sure it is.
Well, no, because we're trying to determine if it's a shiny pan or a dark pan because apparently it matters. What the heck is it? You paid $14 for this?
Yeah.
Wow. I looked at that and I'm like, oh my god, he paid $14 for icing?
Are we gonna need more?
Oh wait, no, it's one stick melted margin, not half, so that's why you need another half.
Hey, you can make a gingerbread shape.
So we got chocolate chip in here. Those are looking so far so good. I'm gonna make a star.
Cause you're a star.
I'm a
star.
A bell, and not so much. I mean, these two are food experts. They would know better than me. Does this look right? I mean, it's not supposed to be mushy.
Yeah.
It looks like mashed potatoes. I mean, that's right though, right? Look at this pan. I know it looks like it's old, because it is. It was my mom's.
It's that character.
Uh-oh.
Done.
Here we go. We got one done. Wait, those look all right. They're not burnt, give me five. All right, one successful batch down. I'll shape them. My job, you are the ploppers, I'm the shaper. And you guys are the testers. Everybody has a job, okay? Too bad we didn't have some other kind of shapes we could make. Look at that.
Oh. Don't throw it away, I'll eat it.
Warm too. Okay, are you really gonna eat it off the floor? You guys are
gonna eat
it. Wait, that. Honey, wait, when my sinks overflowed with somebody's turkey dinner, it wasn't mine, why not? I know. Because there's corn all over my counters, and I didn't even have corn. So, needless to say, everything got sanitized and scrubbed, so it's safe to eat off the floor in here. Speaking of the Corona thing, you should see the cool stuff I got from him. Yeah, it's gonna be cool.
Yep.
It's Christmas. Yeah, we got Cabbage Patch dolls today. I mean, I'm just saying.
Oh boy. I'll take the whole tray home. I'll make sure to get off there.
All right, batch number two.
Praying as we go.
Okay. And then just roll it. Ooh, it's going off my hands.
That's
not working.
That's not gonna work.
Well, we're gonna
then peel the dough away from it.
Oh, it's gonna get all under my nails. I mean, they do it on those food shows and it doesn't look this complicated. I might go into the cookie business. I'll be the cookie gram deliverer. I mean, how's come when they do it on their shows, they just pick it up and it pulls off?
They do it on wood.
No, it's a challenge now. We're not giving up. All right, we're finishing this. All right, somehow.
It's not
going to
work.
It's going to work, okay?
Okay.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy. I'm going to push it all back and make it one big cookie. That's good. We're going to make it two big cookies.
Brownie chocolate.
Okay, 7 minutes. Or eight.
I'll go eight. There's some pretty thick cookies.
Go eight. Gosh. I'll see after that.
Cookies?
Yeah, the tester. You are the official tester so far. Mm. How is it? Good, good.
Good, good.
Okay, throw those away. Prep time, 7 minutes. We should time ourselves and see if it's actually right. Let's run the clock. 7 minutes. Okay, Sam, heat up the butter. Where's the bowl? We're seeing if we can do this in 7 minutes. Okay. Stir softened butter. Oh, wait, let's do that. Thank you. Go team. Oh, look at those, you guys. Your hands. Oh, these are oatmeal. Wait, what's our time? Wait, read on there. It's 11 minutes, especially because some of them are... Oh.
Mine is ruined.
It didn't work.
Look, it all fell apart.
You can't crush
end to
an
end.
Egg.
End to end, you can't crush it.
Wait, from end to end?
End to end.
So if I push on, it's not going to break.
No.
Oh my gosh!
That end
is
nope. End
nothing!
End to end, you can't bust
that
it.
That is so crazy! Wait, I'm trying
just...
it again.
Well, hey, I was trying to watch
end to
this.
End. Oh my gosh! That is bizarre. See? I think everybody should try this at home. Look at that.
Good morning, Youngstown. Guess what time it is? Time to sweat. Oh, come on. The holidays are here, and you know what that means. Guys and girls, it's not just a girl thing. Guys eat cookies and lemon pie and, oh man, peppermint strudels. Okay, just forget about it. Let's get busy. So today, this morning, we're gonna work our arms because nothing worse, ladies, than when you wave and your arm waves back. Bad, 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 bad. So simple little technique to build right through here. Now, if you don't have weights at home or a kettlebell, in which I use, you can take your milk jug, because those are pretty heavy. Put one of those in each hand and wow. Or your laundry soap or anything weighted, anything that you can think of that has a handle, you could lift anything, okay? So, but you could actually go to the store and get a dumbbell for a 5 pound or something. They're minimal costs, like $5 or $10, not a big deal. But for the if you'd rather find something around home, go for it too. All right, enough chit chat. I prefer to use a kettlebell only because I like the way to hold it that way versus the dumbbells. So what you want to do is keep your elbow right into your side so it doesn't move. Because a lot of times when people do these, they keep their arm out here and they're going like that. Wrong technique. That's not going to do anything other than probably throw your shoulder out. So keep your elbow in to where it's right into your stomach. You're going to keep it down all the way to your leg, then slowly bring it up. Now remember, like with anything, we always do 3 sets of 10. However, if you start doing this and you're like, oh man, that's 5 and that's all I can do, that's fine. Because remember, it's always better to start and build than to do them bad and get injured. Try to avoid injury at all costs. So you want to do this nice and slow, because that's what builds the muscle. Because if you do it fast and you're just like this, see what happens? I'm moving my whole entire body, and what's gonna happen is I'm gonna aggravate my back, and I'm not even working the muscle I'm supposed to. And remember to breathe. So when you bring it up, just like so. Switch, remember, keep the elbow in, touching this and right into your side, and slowly bring it up. Come on, you got this. It's only 10. I like to wait probably about a minute, if that, in between sets. Because the idea is to heat up your body and burn calories and build the muscle tone, not to, you know, sip coffee and take 20 minutes in between each set, because that's not going to do anything for you either. Okay? So, this is what we call a kettlebell. You can find those at any of the fitness stores, online, whichever. Or if you prefer the dumbbell, same thing. Keep your elbow in. And up. So either way, or like I said, you don't have any of that and you want to start working out right now, get in your kitchen and grab your milk. What are you waiting on? We'd like to thank Buena Vista Cafe in Warren, graphics designed by James, Artistic Silkscreen and Design, Champion True Value Hardware.
Tiffany, and we got Kelly.
We're doing it. Here,
does anybody tell him that I talk way more than him? This is my mic, baby. Oh, back off. Whoa. You're on the naughty list. Sit down, buddy.
That's
right. All right. In National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, what animal was in the Christmas tree? Oh, you got it. Squirrel. That was right. So am I going to get a Cabbage Patch? That's the only thing I asked for Christmas. I mean, I'm on the naughty list, but it's fine, right? All right, good. I was concerned about that.
I've been an awful good girl, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. And hurry down the chimney tonight.
That's Santa. My hair's a little bit messed up.
And I'ma let you do your thing, yeah. Tonight I'ma let you be a rider.
In the Grinch, where was the Grinch from? What was the town name?
Whoville.
Wait, right there, yes, you got it. Wait, oh, sorry. Sorry about that. Wait, what do you get under your tree if you're bad?
Coal.
Where'd it come from first? Right here, coal. Or is it Rudolph? What did he make a wooden toy for?
Pickle!
Pickle! Who said it? Where is it? Where is it? Who said it? Right over there. Something? Oh my god, Santa! What could have happened to Santa? Did he shave in the bathroom? Wait, if I had Santa's mirror, does that mean I could be Santa? Oh my god, I could drive it. I could drive his sleigh.
The tree.
Whoa.
So we're ready.
All
But Sam, I need the ornaments. I gotta find a skirt though.
Well, that's obviously the top.
Hi, Zig. Oh, this is Ziggy's first Christmas.
I wonder how he's gonna do with the tree.
Sam's a genius.
Yes. Okay. Well, then I'll hold it up. You do it.
Well, here. It's better if I just do it sideways.
Oh.
There. All right.
At least there's no squirrels in here. And they're chasing around.
They have something with nitroglycerin plants.
Oh, yeah, I guess
you
we should
make sure you fold them all the way out.
Plugged it in to make sure we're good and running.
Yes.
Oops, sorry, babe. Okay. And is it all lit?
Yeah.
Perfect. This is the part I hate. Shaping the tree.
Yeah.
One time when I was 16 at the Eastwood Mall, there was this Christmas store and they sold all these ornaments and all these Christmas trees. And I worked there, Sam, and I had to decorate all these trees. And apparently I didn't do a good job because I lasted for like 2 days. And they're like, you have to wrap the lights around it so you can't see. I'm like, what? And I was wrapping them around and apparently it just wasn't right because I have to say I didn't work there very long. Play the song that I sing.
No, Zig, go see that will taste good.
Sam!
Zig?
No, buddy!
Oh, this is bad.
Zig. Skirt. Hey.
Know what happens for people get on the naughty list.
This looks like the Charlie Brown tree. It's looking a little sick.
It doesn't look Charlie Brown tree is like that thing.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Doesn't look right.
No, look, it's got a bear space.
Oh, wait. Hey. Strategically placing, of course.
I wonder where we got that from.
Come here, buddy. Come here. No.
You a ninja.
All right, Zig's going into timeout.
Put some more over here.
Nuh-uh. I'm the one dropping the bulbs on.
Need a hook, Charlie.
Alright,
yellow.
Pink and green.
Oh.
What about, buddy?
How about like a
so, this is the week of Christmas, and the tree is up, cookies are made, kids are in bed. Anyways, from my family to yours, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. And brings you to every year, though, you come to a point where it's Christmas and the new year, and you're like, wow, you remember things from traditions and growing up, and it's probably a pretty sentimental time for a lot of people, and it makes me think of when I was younger. I was my kids' age, and we had we'd go to my aunt's every Christmas Eve, and then it was tradition. Like, you got so excited to go to my Aunt Ev's house and exchange presents, and of course eat like a pig, of course. But And then the next morning, bright and early, me and my cousins, because I had six cousins that are boys that I grew up with, because my mom, her and I, we lived with my aunt and uncle. My mom was a single parent. So it was me and her until I was about 15, and we were out on our own. So I grew up with six boys. So at Christmas time with six boys, yeah, that's a little crazy, huh? But it was the best times ever. And you remember running down, you know, getting your stocking after Santa had just visited. And you're like, wow, you know, with the excitement is in the air. And now to feel that as a parent, the way that I felt, it's unbelievable. The excitement of that, but then you also have, I deal with, and I'm sure a lot of you out there that are watching right now, it's sad a lot of times, the holidays, because a lot of times people are like, well, it's about family and it's about happiness and everything, but sometimes people are sad, and it's tough to get through the holidays, and to be honest with you, that's hard for me, because I lost my mom, you know, like I just told you, she was all I had, she was everything, so to not have her, you know, it's tough. but I have my kids, and it's just funny how things change over the years that were so important to you, but now you're like, wow, that really means nothing at all. And just seeing smiles on their faces, it's unbelievable. But with my mom, she would have made my cookies that I cooked look crazy, because she handmade, you know, everything, and or homemade rather, made everything, and she didn't do the cheater cookies like I did, but it's one of those things that you acknowledge, you're like, well, I'll never be as good as my mom was. But so mom, wherever you might be, sure do miss you. Thanks for all those memories. And for everybody watching, go hug your mom and dad right now, because trust me, sometimes they might not be there. And don't you dare take any of that for granted. So, enough of this crying. It is the holidays. So happy holidays. And I hope I get on the nice list, because, well, I do want that Cabbage Patch doll. This is VIP style. And thanks for watching.